Hey, what's up, you guys? I'm just gonna do a quick video on putting together a thrust tube for the 70mm Detrim combo kit. I get this at hobbyparts.com. It's a nice 70mm EDF. It's got plenty of power too. The battery I run on my jets is a Sky LiPo. It's at 1800 milliamp an hour. 40C discharge, 14.8 volt battery. So it's a 4-cell. If you go on Hobby Parts, you'll see them. It's for the 64mm EDF jets they make, but I use it for the 70. All right, let's get right into this. Here, I picked up some 20-ounce foam cups from the dollar store, which I got one right here. What we're gonna do, I hooked up my ESC already to my ducted fan unit. Just gonna take and stick this down in there. I wanna make sure you line it up real nice, because we gotta make some cutouts for the these little posts on both sides. We gotta be able to get our wires through here too. So I just go ahead and center it on there, just like so. Here you can see where we got a notch out for the little peg sticking off the side. I'm just gonna draw some quick lines real quick. Hit the other side. Make sure your EDF unit's centered. All right, so we can go ahead and pull that back out. Now, if you take and measure this EDF unit from front to back, it's 2.5 inches. So I'll go ahead and put this ruler up here. Set it at 2.5 inches. Mark down here at the bottom. Go ahead and do the other side. All right, so now we're gonna draw some lines to show you what we're gonna do here. We're gonna go ahead and cut these pieces out. But I'm gonna show you, because these wires are hanging out one end on the EDF unit. You're gonna wanna go ahead and add like 1/4 inch onto one side. Something like that. Go in here with my X-Acto knife and cut this out of here. This is one nice thrust tube too for this ducted fan system. Creates a lot of thrust. So we know it was 2.5 inches to the back of the EDF unit, 2.5. Then I went probably 2 3/4 to even up to 3 inches on this side. And what that'll do is it'll allow for our wires now to pass through here. Get these things lined up. We'll be able to squeeze our EDF unit down in there. Then on this side, your wires will be sticking out. Just go ahead and do that right now. So I just feed my wires down through there. Line your EDF unit up. Make sure you get it in there. And this foam is going to wrap right around to the front, just to the leading edge of your EDF unit. Just like so, guys. I got the EDF unit flush with the top of the foam cup. So once we do that, I'm kind of liking right where it is right now. Go ahead and hit this with some hot glue. all around the leading edge here of your fan unit. Like so, guys. Go ahead and let that set up for a second. So now you can see why I cut back an extra quarter inch on this side, because I wanted my wires to be able to feed out through the side. Got the EDF unit nice and flush with the foam. You want the top of the EDF unit to actually sit inside the cup. So now I'll go back and hit these cracks that we made with some hot glue. Go ahead and fill that little chamber up there. Make sure you're connected onto your cup. There's one side. Like so, you guys. I need some more glue sticks. So now I'm gonna flip around to the other side and hit this side with some foam glue or some hot glue. I just try to really fill up that whole little spot that I cut out and make sure you're connected onto your foam. Like that. You'll be able to tell when I paint it just how much hot glue I put down in there. So let that set up for a second. Like I said, this is a real easy way to make your thrust tube. And it's real effective. And this I'll be putting on the black dark wing 70 millimeter. Alright, so while that's cooling off, now I'll take the very top leading edge of this foam cup, and you can see the line there. You're gonna wanna cut off this whole top piece. Following that line right there. Let's grab our X-Acto knife. Go in here and start cutting this. Again, you want to be right on the line. Alright, you guys, so there we remove the very bottom of the cup right on the line. So there you guys have it. Pretty fairly simple. And this will be going on the dark wing plans that I made up. You see, I got the foam cup. Right there. Here's some remnants of the dark wing I had, but I tore it apart so I can just do a build video of one using my plans here. The canopy for the black wing is optional. You can purchase this at a hobby store. Alright, you guys, so now that we got everything put together, show you as I take it right over to the paint booth here and just throw a coat of paint on it. Just fairly simple. Go ahead and clean off your cup of any debris. I'll just take and shoot this with some black. You guys can just do a light coat for your first coat here. Make sure you get down inside the EDF unit. Like I said, I'm just gonna do a light coat real fast. Kinda let that set up for a second. Just go back and put your final coat. There it is, you guys. And you're going to find out that this EDF unit puts out a lot of thrust. You know what? See a spot I missed. I'm going to go ahead and let this dry up. Now again, I use the same thrust system on all my 70 millimeter jets. I'll show you later on how I make it for the 64 millimeter. But I wouldn't even go with 64 millimeter on any of my jets. I would just step right into the 70 millimeter paired with that LiPo battery and that speed controller, and you got a powerful little system. And you would get about 5 minutes, 5 to 6 minutes of flight time on this whole system here, which ain't too bad. There you got your 70 millimeter EDF unit. Placed inside your thrust tube that you made out of a dollar store foam cup, 20 ounce. I could probably go ahead and give you a little example of the thrust it puts out. Plug this into my receiver. I'm gonna turn on my transmitter. There, we're armed. Like I said, this sucker puts out some thrust. Oh yeah, that's one bad boy. Alright, you guys, that's how you build it for the 70 millimeter. I'll get back to you with the build videos for the Darkwing. Over and out.